Hi, my name is Grandpa John. I will guide you through the accounting section of the MBA in pills offered by the 4-week MBA. For more business educational videos, check out this link. We saw in the accounting equation video that the balance sheet is divided in two main sections, the asset section and the liability and equity section. More in detail, the asset section is comprised of current assets and non-current assets. Main current assets are cash, accounts receivable, inventories, prepaid expenses. The current assets are called such because they are usually on the balance sheet for 1 year or less. The current assets are usually listed on the balance sheet according to their degree of liquidity. Therefore, cash is the most liquid, while prepaid expenses, the least liquid. Cash is available at any time. Accounts receivable, sum of money to be received from customers. Inventory, a list of goods to be sold. Prepaid expenses, some paid in advance. The non-current assets are also called long-term assets. Indeed, those are assets that will stay on the balance sheet for years, such as plants, equipment, furniture, and so on. On the other side of the balance sheet, we have the liabilities and equity. Liabilities are comprised of current liability and non-current liability. Current liabilities stay on the balance sheet for less than a year, non-current for more than a year. Let's see the main current liabilities. Accounts payable, sum of money not yet paid to suppliers, that will be washed away once paid. Accrued expenses, sum of money to be paid in the future, such as payrolls or tax. The main non-current liability is long-term debt, such as loans contracted with the bank. Then, the equity. In this subsection are reported items such as owner's equity, retained profits and other kind of stocks issued by the organization. Let's see now few examples. Jim sold $100 worth of clothes. His customer, Janet, paid with credit card. Therefore, this will generate an account receivable for $100 on Jim's balance sheet. Jim has to pay for utilities. Since it is the first time he set up the account, he has to pay for $1,000 in advance. This advanced payment will be shown as prepaid expense. Jim, this month, did not sell part of the clothes he bought in the previous month. The unsold clothes will become part of his inventories. Then, Jim had to pay $50,000 cash to renovate the store. This $50,000 will show on his balance sheet as building improvement, therefore, a long-term fixed asset. Jim buys clothes for $1,000 with credit card. The payment will be processed in 30 days. This transaction will generate an account payable on Jim's balance sheet. Jim goes to the bank to ask for a long-term loan. The bank gives Jim $50,000. This will generate a bank loan, showed under long-term liability on Jim's balance sheet. After a while, Jim accepts a new partner, Jasmine. Jasmine puts $50,000 and becomes equity partner. This transaction will show on the balance sheet as owner's equity. In conclusion, the balance sheet is one of the main financial statements. It is like an instant picture, and it helps us to assess how risky a business is. In fact, when a company is too indebted, you can see it from the balance sheet. If liabilities are too much in comparison to equity, this can be very dangerous for the business. To summarize, the balance sheet is comprised of two main sections. It is an instant of the business, and allows us to see how risky a business is. If you liked this video, and you found the topic interesting, please leave a comment at these links. If you would like to learn more about other topics, contact us. Grandpa John here. You just enjoyed the accounting section of the MBA in pills offered by the 4-week MBA.